POV stands for the point of view. So that is the main crux of the POV project, is around capturing the point of view of the young people. So as a CVS, our mission statement and our forefront of how we work revolves around groups, people and voice. And the POV aligns to that really well, because it's all about collaborating with the groups, so the groups that have been involved within the POV project, and then the people. We've managed to connect the people that come through and volunteer into those different organisations, which is our core infrastructure of what we do, and the voice, actually leading with the young people and capturing their voice. It has been wonderful to see the cross-partnership working, you know, taking place within the POV. The organisations involved are vastly different. There's a huge demographic, and I think that's great if you're watching as a VCSE organisation, third sector charity. I hope that anyone watching this would be able to resonate and relate to any of these organisations and think, actually, I can implement the practices. On a bi-monthly basis, we have a steering group meeting, and that's where all the organisations have a meeting collectively, and they can share what they've done, the progress that they've made within the POV project, actually speak openly and transparently about some of the challenges, but also learn from one another.
Yeah, so I started working with BCVS at the age of 18 through an apprenticeship, and I never worked for a charity before, never even thought about it, never crossed my mind. And seeing that how people can volunteer and then that turn into a job as well is also sort of a push for young people, because not many of them would think about if they volunteered it could lead to further and lead to employment. So it's actually made me quite proud to know that I'm involved in something that can actually lead to develop people in life, and some people that have come from tougher backgrounds and things like that, and they haven't got the qualifications that are perfect. It's made them sort of see that if they volunteer and they're doing something they love and they enjoy, they can actually lead to employment that way rather than going through the generic route.
I think it is about persevering. I think with the young people, I think it took months for us to start off with these little projects to kind of get to where we are now, and we would never have thought that at the start. We were thinking, you know, halfway through the project, we're like, is this working? Are young people getting anything from it? But to have developed a mental health toolkit, and for the young, and to see the pride in the young people who have participated in that, it's been so worth it. So I think it is, and it's about finding, it's engaging young people, and once you've got that core group who are coming, it's then, what are their interests, what are they passionate about, and how can we link that to a project, and how can we get their voices across? So definitely I think it's keep going at it, booking those regular meetings, plan some activities, if it's just getting to know them, getting to know their interests, and then I think the rest of it comes out from there.
Because we're based very close to Chesterfield College, recently in the new academic year, we've gone down to college and introduced ourselves to the art department there. And we were able to then get into their classrooms, and through one of our young people who's part of Junction Arts team, they went into lots of different classes and spoke to the young people kind of face to face, told them about what POV is about and Junction Arts and how they can get involved. And then we found at a recent session, we had lots of new people join. So we went from about kind of 5 regular attendees to 18 people, which is amazing.
The benefits are, there's been more of an engagement with Voluntary Action Doncaster, more of an interest. People are going out of the way to get involved now, which they weren't before.
So before the POV, we didn't really have many young volunteers on site. We had school children here for alternative placements, and that was about it. Through the Point of View project, we could actually offer the young people something they would want to be interested in. We could offer them these arts, these crafts, these ways to explore themselves creatively. And we've always done a bit of mental health work, but not as much as we did before the Point of View project started. And by being able to engage them, giving them opportunities, we can support more people and do our best to help more people.
I've gotten better now at talking to people. That's one thing where I've got a lot better. And my confidence has gotten a bit better as well with doing things. got me a lot better at working with people, because I'm not really good at teamwork. I'm not bad at teamwork, but I don't like talking to people as much, so it obviously forces you to do it in an environment where you kind of got to be professional, so it helps a lot more with like dealing with people when I don't want to deal with them. So that helps.
It could be used as for experience and all for like any jobs you want to do in the future and all. And the reason why I do it, because it could also be fun as well.
Some of the students have expressed the fact that they don't have enough time, and they will tell us that they're time poor. They've also told us that having appropriate volunteering to go to has also been something that may not have been a barrier, but it may have been quite off-putting.
So the POV Project's been brilliant at highlighting some of the barriers that young people face into volunteering. It's been supportive, but that it has highlighted some further barriers that perhaps we weren't anticipating. So through the organisations, one of the biggest ones has been around mental health.
So I think like lack of knowledge that it's going to be happening is one. Like, I only found out about it because I come to the Centre Place LGBT 16 to 25 group on a Wednesday, and that's how I found out about it. But if I didn't come to this group, I wouldn't have found out about it. So I think like the way it's like publicised or like out to the public is not the best. Like, it's always in like places where like young people might not go to often, like the library, for example.
I think social media is a huge thing. I think that's a real surefire way to engage young people, and particularly on like a local scale, if you can see what's popular, what's going round, you know, tap into that.
I think time is one of the biggest ones. Obviously trying to work it around school or working around having a part-time job, because obviously as a young person you want to start making your own money, you want to start driving, things like that, which obviously you can't do if you're not making money. So I think time's probably the biggest one. Another one would obviously be the lack of money in volunteering, because obviously there's a stigma around not having any money. So I think that's quite a big one as well.
Travel. I think a lot of young people, they don't drive, the cost of transport. Flexibility, I think, because some of the young people that we have accessing our services do experience mental health difficulties. That commitment is sometimes quite difficult if, you know, if they're having a day where they're not feeling particularly like they're able to leave the house, that isolation. So we've found like the flexible volunteering be really beneficial. So we could say, we're at this event on this day, can you make it? And they're like, yeah, that's great.
I think a big one for me would be recognition. So my career, I suppose, from being 18 to up until this year, really, involved a lot of volunteering through Junction Arts, but then through other different programmes and organisations. It's about being transparent where opportunities can lead, but also if there was some formal recognition involved. So obviously volunteering is not like an apprenticeship where people can walk away with a qualification as such, but if there was some sort of formal recognition, so when it comes to sitting in an interview, it doesn't heavily rely on the person who's done the volunteering to explain absolutely everything about it, that you can almost walk into an interview or an opportunity and say, I've volunteered for this organisation for X amount of time. And it's just more widely recognised.
We didn't used to do anything like TikTok or anything like that, so we're now engaging in platforms that are more likely to be of interest to young people. It took us a long time to get Facebook in our organisation, so we do Facebook and Twitter, but that's it really. So we have branched out and done TikTok as well, which to engage the young people.
Time, studying, education, it's really important. 5 days a week, you know, and a lot of young people, weekends, you know, they need that time to unwind and relax. And the second one, I'd say probably mental health. That's really big nowadays. And, you know, we've seen a lot of, you know, as awareness has risen, you know, so people coming forward about their problems and things. And it does make it, mental health makes it really hard to engage, you know, with a lot of things, especially, you know, something new like coming to volunteer.
Working with people such as Rhubarb or Centre Place, in terms of they have a different kind of raison d'etre and what they bring to this project is different, and it allows us to kind of see different ways of working with young people, and it gives us an extra kind of capacity, if you like, for engaging young people outside of what we do in the classroom.
One of the targets particularly we had to focus on within the POV project was to engage 100 volunteers, new, you know, young people into volunteering opportunities, and that has now surpassed massively. So we're up to 374, and we still have, you know, a good number of months in the project left, and 292 of those are brand new, first time new volunteers. So it shows that kind of commitment and focus, leading with the voice of the young people, really does change volunteering for the future.